92 tours. It'll be 93 after this stream. What's my opinion on Overwatch? Well, I have a lot of very small opinions about it, but they all kind of add up to one big, like, eh, kind of thing. I think the main thing is that it's really ambitious. It's got 21 classes, and so right now in its early stages, it's not balanced at all. Like a lot of people say, I mean, like that it is balanced, and it is very surprisingly balanced for what it is, but it's not balanced at all. And I don't think that, I mean, it's asking a lot to be like, oh, I can't believe that these 21 classes are not balanced. That's ridiculous. But when I played, I noticed that about a third of the classes were either played a lot in a certain situation, like a lot, and it was almost always effective, or every class, about a third of the classes were not very fun to play against. Like, and that was kind of a big setback for me. I think that a game should be fun to play, and at least in TF2, the stuff that's not fun to play against, like at least they eventually fix that stuff. I hope that they do fix a lot of things about TF2 or about Overwatch that's not very fun to play against. Like for instance, Roadhog's chain. Oh my god, it's so long. Like I've never got used to how long that chain was. Like it was ridiculous. Like I'd be across the map and he'd be able to hit me with a chain and just one shot me with a shotgun. That's ridiculous. He has 600 health too, and the cooldown on his healing item was 5 seconds. 600 health and you can heal every 5 seconds. It's kind of like a little broken, don't you think? And then of course the big one, Mei, not fun to play against at all, because any mechanic in a game, an FPS shooter especially, that hinders your movement is not good. It's not fun. Like it, and the fact that she can freeze you in place with no way to like combat it is kind of ridiculous. Like, maybe if you could aim while you're being frozen, if you could, like, turn, like, what happens is, like, eventually you move slower while she's aiming at you, and then eventually if she gets you in her freeze beam for too long, you eventually completely stop and you can't move. Like, it's almost like your hands are completely off the keyboard and you can't do anything, right? Maybe if you could move your mouse, like, move your cursor to aim, then, it would be a little bit less annoying. Shit. I can't do anything about that. Hopefully they do something about it. What are you doing all the way over here? Oh, shit. This team is not dealing with that Sandman scout very well. I was kind of hoping that they would take the gate before anything else. Hey, thanks for the boots there, dude. And the medal as well. Appreciate it. Another thing that I didn't like playing against in Overwatch was... I didn't like playing against Bastion because he has no fall-off at all, which I'm not used to. So basically, if he can see you, then he can do maximum damage to you. And he does a lot of damage. A lot of damage. And it was kind of annoying, especially because he's just such a good defensive character. Like, he's, like, the best defensive character ever, like, in any video game. Like, it was ridiculous. Like, the only way you could take him out is if you flanked around and took him out while he wasn't looking at you, basically, and hopefully you can out-DM him before he turns around, whips around and kills you. I think that a fix for Bastion would be to maybe when he's in his turret mode, he can't move his aim as fast. Like, whenever you're walking around, you can move your aim fine, but then whenever you go to turret mode, you can still whip around just as fast, and I think that that's probably the problem. Oh, thanks for that BAP. I missed it, actually. Sorry, I was too busy talking about Overwatch here. But the thing is, another problem that I had with Overwatch is that on offense and defense, the respawn timers are exactly the same on defense and offense, which I think is kind of like, you guys have played on no respawn timer servers before, right? And almost every time, unless the teams are amazingly imbalanced, defense always has an advantage while there's no respawn timers, because offense has to walk further, right? So automatically on every map, at least payload and attack defense or whatever the game modes are called, anything except for Koth was oh, thanks for the stuff there, H2 Overdrive. You're gonna go to Elcone. Alright. You can say this is the legendary site of the $1 pizza, right? And they're like, we don't talk about that. So I think that a problem was that defense had a massive advantage at the end of the game, but in the beginning of the game, offense obviously has a bit of an advantage because they're right there, and they don't have to walk very far, they're just right out of spawn, right? So, I mean, with how many things were inspired from TF2, I'm surprised that they didn't take that bit of advice, which was make defense's respawn timer longer than offense's. Like, that just makes sense. I'm not really sure why they're the same. Doesn't really make sense to me. I found that about 75% of the time I was winning on defense, solely because, and it wasn't because of player skill, it was solely because we just respawned faster than they were and they didn't have a Symmetra. So, and there's only 6 slots, so I mean, like, that's a Symmetra that you're, you know, that could be an offensive class, so. I'm gonna hit this button. Loving the 80s. Thanks. I like 80s stuff. I like a wide variety of music. 80s is one of my faves, though. Torbjorn is Uncle Dane. Yeah, yeah. It's a lot like the engineer, but he's a lot better. He can build sentries a lot faster. And his ult is kind of ridiculous. It basically makes him and his sentry invincible at the press of a button. Oh, thanks, Blue Star, for the 2 decades. Appreciate the support as usual, and hope you enjoy those emotes as much as I do. I really am excited once we get to 100 to add some more emotes, because emotes is like is the main reason that I even applied for a partner here. Thanks for the hat there, Insane Llama. Really appreciate the. Why did we miss 100 again? Oh, it's because Bill Cosby timed out again. Bill Cosby's like literally playing from his phone. He has tethered to his laptop or something. That's ridiculous. Ah, shit. What else about Overwatch? A problem that I can see with it, especially since they're going the esports route, which is, you know, basically what any modern game really wants to do nowadays, is, you know, appeal to the esports crowd. Oh, thanks for the skinned wrench there, Lady Stanger. Really appreciate the donation there. Lady Stanger. I used to think your name was Stranger, by the way. I don't know if that's a fun fact about you. And then we've got a killstreaker for the fire heavy gun? Qlong here. Problem with Overwatch that I saw, especially since they're going down the esports route, is that it's, one, hard to follow if you don't play the game, which I guess isn't really that much of a problem. It's just that if you don't know what all the characters do and what is happening when people are fighting, then you're going to be so lost. Like, I watched a lot of Overwatch, and it took me a really long time, and I didn't even play Overwatch at the time. I watched a lot of it before I played it. I watched probably about 10 hours worth of streams of Overwatch, and it took me a really, really long time to understand what all the characters did, and I actually never really did eventually understand what every character did until I started playing it, and I actually, like, sat down and, like, did research. And that's kind of inherent of MOBAs. Like, MOBAs have that same kind of thing. They have so many characters and so many, like, ways to interact with things that you have to, like, do your research before you can understand what's going on. And that's kind of a negative thing, I guess. I mean, as far as esports go, I like... The thing I like about Counter-Strike is... you can go in and watch Counter-Strike, and you can tell, like, when people get shot. Like, it's pretty simple. Like, people get shot, there are certain guns that shoot bullets fast, and some that shoot them really quickly but do a lot more damage. You know what I mean? Like, that kind of thing is really easy to understand. But Overwatch is very complicated. And I noticed that as far as a lot of the, the professional Overwatch streams, I watched a few of those. There are a lot of team switch. There's a lot of class switching. And, oh shit. He destroyed my sentry immediately. Oh, I hate these guys so much. Okay, he needs to capture this point right now, or else we're gonna lose. Oh my god, go away, dude! Oh my god, I hate that. Same with TF2 classes? I don't know about that, there's only 9 of them. And, I mean, sure, you need to know, like, what certain weapons do, but, I mean, anybody who watches, like, competitive TF2, like, you can kind of tell what's going on. I mean, maybe the demo sticky bomb launcher is kind of confusing. Maybe, you know, how are the soldiers flying? That might be a little confusing. How is any character flying in this game? I don't understand, like, that kind of thing, maybe. But, like, that's nothing compared to Overwatch. Like, really, like, my experience with Overwatch is I had to learn a lot before I understood everything that was going on. And I still kind of don't understand what's going on. Like, Symmetra, like, I don't understand a lot about that class. I don't think I played a second of her because she was very complicated. And, you know, Genji, like, I'm sure it's a very linear class, but I didn't learn anything about it. I didn't have time to learn everything about all the classes. It's just, I mean, it's not like it makes it a bad game. Oh, please, please, please. It's not like it makes a bad game. It's just, it's going to be a little harder for people who don't play Overwatch to watch Overwatch. Okay. I guess I only killed one guy. Well, we're all dead, actually. Bah! Easy to memorize counters, pyro, counter spy. Yeah, like, I'm not even sure what counters what in that game. But I'm very new to it, so that could be part of it. Thanks for the
Whoa,
items there.
You're epic.
Didn't actually see it. Wiffle Sniffer with 2 decades. Thanks, Wiffle underscore Sniff. Wiffle Sniffer. Sniffing those Wiffles since 1998.
Whoa, you're epic.
I'm going to go out on a limb here and say that we are going to lose this round, but I think that's just because the beginning was very, very sloppy. And of course, the one that everybody else kind of complains about is that, and I think the most controversial, because it seems like every time I mention this, people get really mad, but I'd say that if you're going to compare TF2 and Overwatch has a lot less mechanical skill, and that means that in order to move around the map, you can just walk there and press a button, and there's not a whole lot else to learn about it. Like, for instance, somebody who's really good at rocket jumping is going to have a big advantage over somebody who doesn't know how to rocket jump as well. And I think that that's really cool. I think that a lot of people like that about TF2, is that if you put in the time, if you put in the effort, and put in, a couple hours of your day for a year, like, you can become pretty good at the game. But Overwatch, I felt like I got pretty good at the game in, like, a couple days. Like, I felt like, as far as, like, when it came to, like, fighting players, I was usually the MVP, and that's coming from somebody who doesn't know very much about the game itself. We need to take care of this engineer. Okay, there we go. So, like, that's kind of not very attractive, is that somebody who's not very familiar with the game can be good at it. Like, I know that a lot of people would much rather that the pros are pros. Oh, please. Alright, well, it's better now than later, I guess. I missed your BAP, I'm sorry. What graphical setting can you play Overwatch? I played it in whatever the default was one. I never changed any of my graphical settings and the game ran fine. But I've got a pretty decent video card, so probably why. I learned how to mind jump in 20 seconds. Well, it's not hard. Like, I mean, like, the thing is, like, look, I still can't do this perfectly. Like, sometimes I just can't, especially when I'm on a server that lags. You know, I still can't sentry jump perfectly. Like, it's something that it's, you need to practice, you need to get really good at it, you need to, like, that's really attractive. Another thing about Overwatch, and I think this is the last thing that I can really mention before I stop talking about another game while I'm streaming TF2. The thing I noticed was that it's really hard to carry in Overwatch. Like, if you're way better than your other teammates, like, I sometimes, and I'm not sure if this was an accident or whatever, if the way that the game pairs up other players is broken right now because it's in beta, but I got paired up a lot with people who were like 10 or 20 levels below me, and every time I did, I felt like I was the only one who was really doing anything on my team. I was like, you know, everybody else is kind of obviously very new. They were still trying to figure out everything. They were testing out characters they've never played before, you know, running around, like, pressing their abilities when they don't need to just to see what they do, that kind of thing. And, you know, when I'm on that kind of team, it's extremely hard to win because 2v1s in that game are nothing like 2v1s in TF2. If you are a pyro and you're fighting a demo man and a soldier, you might actually win if you can hit all your reflex, right? 2v1, like, those are two very powerful classes, but if you're a pyro, you can probably win if you're really good, right? That's not the same in Overwatch. If you're playing against two relatively bad players and you're really good in Overwatch, you're probably not gonna win because just every character just does so much damage, and every character just has it's really easy to play. Like, it's just really easy to play every character, and so every player can hold their own almost 100% of the time. Like, no, I okay, there we go. I was so pissed for a second. I thought I wasn't gonna be able to make it. All right, here we go. We got the sentry in the decent spot here. Okay, scouts after it. Did the scout get it? Oh my god. So yeah, 2v1s, really hard to 2v1 any character in that game. It was kind of frustrating because, I mean, as engineer, like, I can take out a heavy medic combo if I flank them, right? As engineer, like, because I have pretty good aim. Like, if I'm using the Widowmaker especially, like, I won't have to reload. Like, like, that's really cool. And so, I feel like the thing that's missing in Overwatch is that a good player in Overwatch doesn't have a huge opportunity to just completely destroy other players. You know what I mean? Like, I was never on a team where I was just like, that Tracer carried them. It's like, that Tracer is annoying, but we're gonna win anyway because the rest of their team isn't very good. Which means that teamwork is so important in that game that it might be actually detrimental. Because, I don't know if you guys have ever played MOBAs, but everybody always complains that the big thing about, like, lobbying in MOBAs, especially with randos, is that you have to rely on your team so much. You have to rely on other players, and that's not good in a team game that relies so much on teamwork, because sometimes it's just not there. Like, in pubs, in TF2, in pubs, if you have a bad team, and there's one player on their team, just one good soldier, you probably aren't gonna win, because that soldier is just gonna completely carry, and that's really cool, I think. I mean, like, you guys might not think it's very fun, but if you're that soldier, then you earned it. Like, you've been playing long enough to go and carry in a pub. Like, you've earned it. Like, that's cool. But if you're really good at the game, you've put in 2,000 hours into a game, and you still can't win because your team sucks, that's not fun. Like, that's just not fun. Like, yeah, I don't know. I think that might be something that might hold Overwatch back, but that's just me. I died in a 1v1 where one symmetric killed everyone. It's hilarious. I mean, it is a very random game. I did mention, I think in a tweet, that I think that Overwatch might have played better as a pub game and had the pub aspect be the main aspect of it, kind of like how TF2 is, because of how random everything is and how, like, and how basically it's a race to see who can get to who can press Q the fastest, basically. Another small complaint that I had was that the plays of the game seemed very reliant on if you denied an ult at any point, or if you did a whole heck of a lot of damage, or if you killed. Why is nobody killing that guy? Was I the only guy that saw that? Yeah, it must have. Yeah, he definitely killed everybody with his. He's dead now. Oh, sick, I'm getting revived. What was I saying? I forget what I was saying. Oh yeah, it was, Overwatch might have been a better pub game. But I don't know. I'm not an expert on that. Just small opinion that I have. a form of speculation, I think, is the word. Sorry, I haven't been reading chat. I've been mostly kind of just talking and trying to play. Because they didn't cap. For some reason, I thought they capped. Oh! That was mildly surprising. But anyway, I haven't bought Overwatch, and I don't know if I will until they fix things. And they might fix things before it even comes out, because they have 2 weeks to basically take everything, all the feedback from the beta, and apply it. So, and Blizzard is a really good game company. I really like how they handle Hearthstone. Hearthstone is a really well-handled game, a really well-developed game. If they end up developing Overwatch anything like that, then it's going to be a successful game, there's no doubt about it. But the TF2 killer? I don't know, because I feel like comparing TF2 and Overwatch is just so unfair. Like, TF2 has had 10 years to perfect 9 classes, and it's still not perfectly balanced. It's pretty close, but it's not perfectly balanced. And Overwatch just came out, and they have 21 classes to balance, and they're going to add, like, 15 more, I hear. So, I mean, good luck to them. But it's just not fair, I think. I think the TF2 is just a much better game just because it's been out longer. It doesn't mean that Overwatch will eventually become a better game, though. But it's pretty good so far. It was really fun. I had fun when we were winning. But when you lose, it's not fun because you get countered by characters that you feel you shouldn't have died to. And, yeah. But when you win games, when you do clutch, when you press Q and you get the clutch play of the game, that's pretty fun. And,